Yes! In this video, we will be going over the 10 best yellow units that are currently having the strongest impact in the meta game. For this list, Legends limited characters will be considered at 3 stars, and all other units will be considered at 7 stars. As always, non-Zenkai units will also be considered at 3 and 6 stars to weigh in on how useful they are. And at number 10, we have Rage Trunks. He is a fantastic substitute for better yellow units that are higher up on this list, especially in the Vegeta family, Future, and Hybrid Saiyan teams. His health and defensive stats are very good, especially for a non-Zenkai unit. He can increase his damage, remove the opponent's buffs, and heal himself. He's also a defensive unit, as he's quite tanky and a great Rising Rush target, as he can unlock himself when the opponent clicks the Rising Rush button. However, his strike and blast attacks don't hold up, especially as new Zenkai units are released. Basically, this unit has been power crept. His second unique allows him to pile on extra damage, but to use it, your team needs to take damage in a meta where a single combo can kill off a unit. Furthermore, this buff can be cancelled. As a whole, this unit is only really usable at 7 to 9 stars minimum, as he's dead weight at lower stars. Though he's been replaced as a core unit on all of his teams, at least he can be used as a substitute on meta-relevant tags, earning him the number 10 spot on this list. And at number 9, we have God of Destruction Champa. This unit is a great substitute on Godki if you don't have Zenkai 7 God Vegeta. He is also a core unit on the Rival Universe team, which did see competitive play in the top 100 teams from last season. He has the ability to restore his own health and ki, nullify color disadvantage, add debuffs to the opposing unit, massively increase his own damage stats, and potentially mobilize the opponent, thus setting up a potential KO. He also allows for more switch-ins if he takes hits. However, his true weakness is in his stats. His health and defensive stats aren't impressive, allowing him to be killed in one combo by most Zenkai units. Furthermore, he doesn't get his double buff ability until he's at 6 stars. Overall, Champa is a fantastic substitute unit for Godki and a core unit on the Rival Universe tag that deals effective damage even at 3 stars, earning himself the number 9 spot on this list. And at number 8, we have Zenkai 7 Goku Youth. This unit is a substitute on two of the best tags in the game, Sun Family and Saiyans. He has the ability to revive himself at 20% health, restore his own health and ki, increase his card draw speed, and buff the team's damage. He also has a decent mini crisis kit and an ult that nullifies revival skills. Overall, he has respectable stats, making him an all-around tanky and powerful unit. His strike attack stat, in particular, is impressive. However, this unit needs to be at least Zenkai 6 to be effective, and he's getting power crept by newer units. His green card is inefficient and hard to use, and he doesn't buff his tags effectively, apart from Legends Road, which is currently an irrelevant tag in the meta game. Overall, because he's used as a substitute or even a core unit on Sun Family teams in the top 100, he earns the number 8 spot on this list. And at number 7, we have Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan Gogeta, otherwise known as Super Saiyan Blue Gogeta. Even at 2 stars, this unit sees consistent, relevant play within the top 100 teams, and he works well on many different teams. He has a high strike attack stat and a good health stat for a non-Zenkai unit. He also has an insane ki restore speed and can nullify cover changing. Furthermore, if his green card goes off, he has complete control of the combat loop for 10 timer counts and can essentially nuke the opponent within that time. However, Gogeta lacks in terms of his defensive stat, even at higher stars, which is bad for what is essentially a false defensive unit. If the opponent uses a strike arts card and Gogeta cover changes into the battle, he can knock them back and activate a special move arts card that will deal a lot of damage. However, if he switches in without the cover change skill, he will essentially just die. Furthermore, he doesn't consistently get combos or increase his draw speed, and he takes some time to rev up. As a result, though he can be used in sagas from the movies, God Ki, and Fusion Warrior teams, he is only a core unit on Fusion Warriors. God Ki and sagas from the movies simply have access to units that are better than Gogeta, putting him at the number 7 spot on this list. And at number 6, we have Legends Limited Zenkai 7 Piccolo. From what was seen from the top 100 players of last season, he was the primary yellow unit for regeneration. And without a doubt, this is because his stats are insane, especially after his transformation. His base health stat is already very good, but once he transforms, he has the highest health stat out of any unit in the game, which certainly means that he deserves a spot on this list. His other stats are also some of the highest in the game, making him a tanky unit and a force to be reckoned with. Furthermore, his abilities can be overwhelming to fight against. On transformation, he regains his vanish gauge, allowing him to continue dodging. He also has the ability to apply debuffs, restore his team's health over time, decrease the damage he receives, and increase the damage he deals. He's a great defensive unit, offensive unit, and even anchor to his team. Basically, he can do it all. However, there is another yellow regeneration unit that currently outshines him and is currently seeing more competitive play than this unit. Of course, that may change in the future as the meta shifts, but for now, he only earns the number 6 slot on this list. And at number 5, we have Legends Limited Super Saiyan Gohan. He is the primary yellow unit for Future, and a decent unit for Hybrid Saiyans, often serving as a substitute for Goten on the top 100 teams of last season. His stats are decent, but his kit is what really helps him shine. He destroys 2 cards upon cover changing, he nullifies and counters blast card attacks, and he has a revival skill that brings him back to 40% health. His ult card also allows him to kill off units that would revive, making him a great counter to himself, ironically. He is a fantastic defensive unit, a good Rising Rush target, and a great team player as his skills allow him to increase his own damage and help out his teammates. Therefore, he's never dead weight and really helps Future stay out of Tier 2. This unit sees a lot of competitive play, so he's not one that should be underestimated. However, it's his lackluster stats that land him at number 5 on this list. And at number 4, we have Transforming Kid Goten. He is the core member of both Hybrid Saiyans and Sun Family. His stats are respectable for a transforming unit, but he is not the ultimate wizard in terms of attack and defense. However, he deals respectable damage to Zankai units after he transforms. Now, what makes this unit great is that he has many abilities that help him as a solo unit and also help his team. Goten will increase your ki, your ki restoration speed, and your overall damage. Essentially, he will caffeinate your entire team for you. So thank you, Goten. That's some good coffee. Furthermore, Goten can increase his card art speed by 2 whole levels for 10 timer counts and can heal himself by 20%. Goten is the best supporting unit for both of his teams and sees consistent representation within the top 100 teams of this and last season. Because of this, he deserves the number 4 spot on this list. And at number 3, we have Zankai 7 Super Saiyan God Vegeta. He heals, he does tons of damage, he can continue combos, he's an overall massive tank that can also disrupt opponents upon cover changing. He's arguably the best yellow God Ki unit we've received in a while. His health is decently high, meaning that he consistently sees great usage, especially on God Ki teams. Now, this is a unit that both assists and gets assisted by his team in order to use all of his skills optimally. This unit increases damage in a variety of ways, and also has a lot of ways to increase his own health. He's also bolstered by any unit that can help with his own healing. The only reason why he isn't higher on this list is because he loses one of his unique abilities if his health is lower than the opposing unit when he enters the battle. However, that is not to discredit this unit. Even without all of his abilities, he still does tons of damage and is a fantastic unit overall. He is a main core member on Vegeta Family, Sagas from the Movies, and God Ki. He is primarily a defensive unit, but he can also be used as an anchor or an offensive unit. Since he can play as all three, he is a fantastic unit no matter what point you're at in the game, and thus deserving of the number 3 spot on this list. And at number 2, we have Zankai 7 Demon King Piccolo. Demon King Piccolo belongs to one of the best tags in the game, which is Regeneration. He can also work in powerful opponents and Dragon Ball Saga teams. What makes this unit impressive is that he holds 2 Strike Arts cards and can control the Rising Rush meter. His main ability only requires 15 seconds to activate, after which he can steal up to 2 of your opponent's Dragon Balls. Therefore, you will be able to use the Rising Rush earlier than usual, and may also be able to perform multiple Rising Rushes, that is, if your opponent is even alive at that point. This unit deals massive strike damage and nullifies your opponent's revival skills, excluding Revival Red Cell. This unit really does it all. Increased strike damage, increased card art, draw speed, ki recovery, health restoration, and debuffs. There's literally not a single thing that this unit does not do very well, outside of maybe blast cards. But even his blast cards are not totally wasted, meaning that he still does effective damage there too. His green card even allows him to draw a new hand, allowing him to continue his combos. This unit is fantastic all around. He can act as a defensive pivot, a starting unit, or an offensive unit. In the top 100 teams of last season and this season, almost every regeneration team is using him. The only reason why LF Piccolo saw more competitive play than Demon King Piccolo was Android 21 Good's recent release and a lack of access to Majin Buu Good's Zenkai banner. But even so, Demon King Piccolo is currently a better overall unit than LF Piccolo, as he is great from the start and doesn't need time to set up, thus earning him the number 2 spot on this list. Before we reach our number 1 spot, we have to talk about some honorable mentions. Both Hit and Transforming Yellow Vegito have been replaced on their respective teams. However, they can still be brought in as alternative units and just barely miss the cusp of the number 10 spot. Our number 10 Rage Trunks beats them out as he is an alternative unit for 3 different teams, while Hit and Vegito only work on 1 or 2 teams that are less relevant in the meta. As well, Zenkai 7 Final Form Frieza was just released a couple of days ago and hasn't had a chance to prove himself. Otherwise, he would definitely be making his way onto this list. And at number 1, we have Zenkai 7 Android 18. And yeah, there's a reason why she is number 1. Her damage output is so oppressive and so disgusting that it makes us wonder why she was buffed so much. Now, as an 18 fan, I'm not complaining, but I am well aware of the fact that her damage output might be too much for the game right now until we see better defensive pivots and defensive units. She can literally combo almost anything in the game, especially with her passive abilities being constantly activated. She holds 2 blast cards, which when she wasn't a Zenkai, definitely held her back. But with her new kit, she can take advantage of her blast arts, or change them into strike cards. On top of that, her passives allow her to deal more damage to the opponent each time she uses a strike arts card. Each time the opponent switches characters to reduce the overall damage, she regains 20 ki, while also increasing her draw speed by 1. This means that her combos could technically go indefinitely, as long as the opponent keeps switching. As her green card decreases her strike arts costs, and her passive increases the card drawing speed. On top of that, her blast arts recover 10 ki every time they're used, and her strike arts cards stack damage each time they're used. Therefore, until the opponent stops switching, she becomes a one-woman killing machine. Even if the opponent stops playing defensively, she still does so much damage that, unless they're sitting on a Zenkai 7 red unit, she will most likely still kill it in one combo. Furthermore, when her ult card hits, it locks the opponent's strike arts cards for 7 timer counts, which shuts down a lot of meta teams. Although this unit does not have a rising rush manipulation, kind of like Demon King Piccolo, her kit is so overpowered that to give her this additional skill would make her oppressive in the meta, not that she already isn't. Overall, she is such a powerful unit that she is a core member on both female warriors and androids and rarely gets left on the bench. She is a great starting unit, defensive unit, and offensive unit. Basically, she can do it all. I think that alone says enough about why she deserves the number 1 spot on this list. So do you agree with this list? If you don't, comment down below and tell me what you think. Anyways, have yourselves a salty day. Don't forget to tickle the like button, and if you haven't already, subscribe. And don't forget to obviously click the bell for more notifications so you never miss another video. And I will see you in the next video. Mana mana. Saitama!